Hello students, welcome to the next lecture of the SQL tutorial. In the last lecture we talked about the updation clause and delete clause, how we can update the value in a table and how we can delete the records from a table. In today's lecture we will talk about the like operator. This is basically an operator used for the pattern matching, and it is a very important operator when we use to perform the query. Because in many websites we have to perform queries based on different categories, different criteria, so this like operator is very important. So the like operator is used in where clause to search for a specified pattern in some value, in some column value, and it is used to search for the specified pattern. So let's see what is the syntax of this like operator. So obviously we are fetching some value, so we'll write select, then we'll supply all the column names which we want to fetch, and if you want to fetch all the column names from the table, so we'll supply the wildcard asterisk here. Then the from clause and the name of the table from which we want to fetch the data. Then comes the where clause, where this like operator will be applied. So in the where clause we'll write the column name, then a space, then like, L-I-K-E, like is the operator name, and then we'll supply the pattern. So how we can supply the pattern? Just to supply the pattern, we will use some wildcards like underscore, question mark, and percentage, so that the pattern is supplied to the table in the where clause. So let's see an example. So you can see this is an example where we want to fetch the data like where city, the city name starts from the S. Let's say we want to fetch the person details of all cities whose name starts from S, like say S is Surat, it will give you the all the details of the person who belong to city Surat. So how this can be done? So let's see, this is a select asterisk, we want to fetch all the columns from table name where, then we'll supply the name of the column and then the like operator, and you can see we have used here an operator wildcard basically. So this is a percent single quote, so in the single quote we have written first S, so this will indicate that the first letter has to be S, and after that we can have any characters. So this is a wildcard percentage supplied for any number of characters, and we are not aware about what are those characters. So this will give you the all cities whose name begin with S. So in that case you can fetch all the cities, the data, all the cities of which starts from S, you will get. Let's say if you want to fetch the data of all cities where there is an S in between, anywhere in between. So we do not know what are the characters in beginning, we do not know what are the characters in the end, but we know that there is S in between somewhere. So let's say for that we will be using this single quote, then we'll write a percentage because we are not aware about the characters in the beginning, then we'll supply S, and then again a percent because we are not aware about that what are the characters in the end. So this will fetch, so this will supply the city names in which there is an S in between anywhere of the name, right? So this will be the result. So this is how we can fetch the data. Let's take another example where you have the city names which ends with B. So if ends with B, so that means we know the end character, but we do not know the previous characters. So single quote, then we'll add a percentage because we do not know what are the beginning characters, and then we'll write a B. And obviously we'll not write a percent in the end because this is the last character of the string, and then single quote. So this will fetch the result from all the cities which end with a B, for example Punjab. So this is how we can do this. Let's say if we are aware about that second character. So let's say if we know that what is the second character, so let's say we want all the cities whose second character is U. So we know that this is the second character. We know that before this there is one more character, but we are not aware about that what is the character. So for single character we use underscore. So this is a wild card which is used for a single character. So that will indicate that there is a single character, and the character can be anything. Then we'll write U. So this is the second character, and then we'll write a percent. So this will be indicating that after U there could be any and many characters. So this will fetch all the cities whose second character is U. For example, Lucknow. So this is how you can use the pattern matching criteria, and you can fetch the queries. Let's see one more example here, in which we are select asterisk from persons where last name like. So you can see the last name where we know the first character, we were not aware about the second character. So we have a dash on place of second character, then the sequence of three characters, and again we are not aware about the character, then again a dash, underscore basically, and then on. So this is second. So this is how we can replace the underscores for the places on which we are not aware about that what are the characters. So this is how we can use the pattern matching. For detailed patching pattern matching, if you want to know, you can comment and you can contact me. Let's see the next SQL alias. So alias basically is a name given to the table or some columns. So that is the alias. Let's say we find out the average of some salaries, and AVJ salary is not a good way to represent the column, so we need to replace the name of the column. So in that case we use aliases. So let's say how the alias can be written for the table or for the columns. So we use as keyword for that. So if you want to replace the table name with some name which we would like to give, so we will use table name as and then alias name, right? And if you want to rename the column, so this is select column, the original column, then as, and then the column name we would like to give. So this is how the alias can be used, and these are very good to represent the data. For example, let's say select, here it is a po.orderid. So po.orderid, p.lastname, p.firstname from person, and now the table person is replaced by a shorter name, that is P, right? And the product underscore order is replaced by a shorter name PO. So instead of using those larger names of the table, we can replace them by a smaller name using the alias. So this is how we can use the alias to rename the tables, because this renaming is not done into the physical structure. This renaming is only presentable in the result of the query. So this is not actually renaming the table or renaming a column. This is just a better representation into a result of a query. So it will not permanently effective. It will only be effective into the result for that specific query for a better representation. So that's it for the lecture. In the next lecture, we will talk about some more clauses of the SQL. Thank you so much.